Hey, welcome to Apple A Day. In today's episode, I'm going to talk about cleaning up audio, and I use RX10 Advanced from iZotope. That software is amazing. It's a little bit pricey, but if you're doing anything commercial or professional and you need clean audio, it is the best software out there, at least from what I've used. I've been using this software since RX8. I was actually going to do this video with RX9, but I noticed that RX10 was out, so I upgraded, and I'm going to show you how I clean up my audio in RX10. So let's get started. I already have a file open. This is the audio that I recorded for my introduction video. And when you hear it, you'll realize, wow, there's a lot of hum, there's a lot of echo, things like that. And the software from iZotope lets me clean that right up. So I'm going to play the raw audio right now, and you can hear the problems with it, and then I'm going to show you how I fix it with RX10. I'm a Final Cut Pro user. I use Apple Motion. I use the Adobe Suite. I also use the Affinity Suite. So you can hear the hum, you can hear the echo, and there's a lot of noise. So the first thing that I always repair is the hum. So I'm going to click on de-hum to bring up the tool, and I'm just going to highlight an area here. So the way I used to fix this is I would highlight an area of the audio that only has the hum, so I could press the learn button, and then I would select the entire file by just pressing Command A and hit render. If I play this back, I'm a Final Cut Pro user. I use Apple Motion. I use the Adobe Suite. I also use the Affinity Suite. You can hear that hum is completely gone. Now that's the old way I used to do it. What they've added in RX10 is adaptive mode, which lets it figure things out for itself. So if you click on that, the learn button becomes disabled. I'm going to undo what we did. So the hum should be back. And if I just select the whole thing with adaptive mode selected, just press render. But if I play it back,
I'm a Final Cut Pro user. I use Apple Motion. I use the Adobe Suite. I also use the Affinity Suite.
So you can see the hum is also gone. I do think that using the learn option to select a piece of the audio that has a hum and then rendering it based on that, it'll give you a slightly superior result. But in a pinch, the adaptive mode does work pretty good. So I'm just going to leave it at that and go on to the next thing that I need to fix. So what I used to do next in RX9 was get rid of any reverb, get rid of any mouth clicks, get rid of any de-essing, which is that harsh S sound that sometimes you can get. And the last thing I would do was get rid of any background noise. And those are all separate steps. Some of them you can automate as a batch, but others do require you to use a learn command in order to make the repair. But I'm not going to do that here. I'm going to use something new that they added in RX10 called the Repair Assistant. So I'm going to select that. It's on the top right of the screen. And it's already got some presets in here. You've got a DS, you've got a D-click, which gets rid of mouth clicks. You've got a D-clip, which repairs any audio that's too loud. You've got D-noise and D-reverb. It's already set up. So I'm going to select a section of audio. I'm going to press preview, and you'll be able to hear what it does out of the box without me making any changes.
I'm a Final Cut Pro user. I use Apple Motion.
So as you can hear, it pretty much fixes everything with a single click. I didn't have to do anything. So something that used to take 4 or 5 manual steps, or even those same steps using the batch editor, now can occur with a single click using this repair assistant. So I'm going to select the entire file that I have and render it, and we'll see how this sounds at the end.
I'm a Final Cut Pro user. I use Apple Motion. I use the Adobe Suite. I also use the Affinity Suite.
Now here's the original for comparison.
I'm a Final Cut Pro user. I use Apple Motion. I use the Adobe Suite. I also use the Affinity Suite.
So that's basically two clicks. One click for the de-hum, one click for the repair assistant to do everything else. This software has been a lifesaver for me. Not only for my own personal recordings, like for instance this YouTube channel, but also for my clients. The software is a little bit pricey and a lot of overkill, even for what I use it for. I barely scratch the surface of this. I only use maybe 10% of the features, but it's incredibly reliable and it does perform the cleanup process rather quickly on my MacBook Pro. I can't recommend the software for everybody, mostly because of the price, but if you're a professional and you have clients that require a high quality finished product, I certainly recommend getting this software. I hope this was helpful. I hope you could see how well this software works to clean up audio problems. As always, thank you for watching. I'm John Martins. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time on Apple A Day.